here at Broward Sinus and Allergy, opening up some sinuses with our balloon. Our anesthesia is via Dr. Eberhardt, and patients love him. He is their favorite. And as we get to do a very thorough job and do exactly what we need to see, and our patients have a very pleasant experience here. Okay. Thank you, Nicole. Nicole and Michelle are assisting me today. As we're just making some adjustments in the anatomy here, make our patient breathe a little better. Very good. And then over here, we have traced out our CAT scan of the patient, and it correlates with our instruments to give us this. That is perfect. It correlates with our visualization. It gives us extra comfort and safety. And we are going to be opening up this young lady's maxillary sinus with our balloon. It's in her left sinus now. If you will, Michelle, inflate the balloon.
Inflated.
And as you see, our patient's very comfortable, having a very good experience. Deflate the balloon.
Deflated.
We're right where we need to be. You can see the opening that we're making in that maxillary sinus already. Open, inflate the balloon.
Deflated.
I'm going to do this several times, dilating, making the opening bigger so the sinus resumes a more normal function. Inflate, please.
Inflated.
Very good. Deflate.
Deflated.
Come on out. And you see very clearly the nice opening that we've made in her sinus. And we can do several of the sinuses the same way. And we'll keep proceeding with this case and moving right along. That opening will stay open and continue to function long term. There's no reason why it should shut down. We have the free air to it. Thank you. And here we're just moving the turbinate. And we're going to be now in her right maxillary sinus. And this is the sinus on the CAT scan that's got her worst disease. Inflate.
Inflated.
Deflate.
Deflated.
Inflate.
Inflated.
Deflate.
Deflated.
Inflate.
Inflated.
Inflate.
Deflated.
Deflated. Okay. So, we have made a very nice opening into that sinus, so it will continue to drain. Somewhat to this side, but once we've made some adjustments here, we have plenty of room. we're going to the back of our nose. And the CT is very helpful here in guiding us into her sphenoid sinus, right there. Inflate.
Inflate it.
Deflate it.
Deflate it.
Inflate.
Inflate
it. Deflate.
Deflate
it. Okay, let's go to the other side. Same thing on this side. Inflate.
Inflated.
And again, correlating this to be in the sphenoid sinus on a CAT scan is very helpful, particularly for these. Deflate.
Deflated.
Inflate.
Inflated.
See how we're in that right sphenoid right there? Mm-hmm. Deflate.
Deflated.
Very good. And that completes the procedure. Took about 15 minutes, 10, 15 minutes. How long did it take?
7 minutes.
Yeah.
7 minutes. And she's going to wake up with a very pleasant experience here and no significant pain and heal up relatively quickly in a few days. So back to normal activity.
What are you doing now?
I'm injecting her inferior turbinate with a little Kenalog, an anti-inflammatory steroid, which helps with the healing and inflammation afterwards and the general reduction in the size of these inferior turbinates, which will help her breathe better in the long run. Well done, sir.
All right. Nice.